Yo, I haven't been playing something, so yeah, I'm just gonna quickly check if the SoundCloud works here. Okay. So this is SoundCloud, and I'm just gonna switch over to the DAW real quick and play something here. Can you hear that? So should work. Gonna switch. Cool. For that one. So let me know when I can start the music, and then we're good.
Off, 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 off
What is going on, everybody? Super, super, super excited for our last base time here, streaming to the public the first time, which is super exciting. I'm just gonna switch over to the DAW real quick. And yo, what's good? So, I'm just gonna turn the music off here. And yeah, so today we will stream for the very first time to the public with BaseTime. So we're streaming on their Facebook site, we're streaming on their YouTube, which is super exciting. And I hope a lot of people will join. And today for the last BaseTime with me, we have something really exciting going on, because we will be doing a little 60-minute track challenge. So I try to create a track in 60 minutes, which is kind of funny because I never did that. So the first time will be with you guys and you will see me fail or not fail. So let's see if that works or not. Just a little quick introduction here for me. Just want to say that the stream on YouTube doesn't seem to work. It still says wait on Bass Gorilla. So maybe you could take a look at that again. At least on my end, just let me know if that works or not. And then I'm just gonna quickly check one more time. Maybe it's just on my end. I'm just gonna reload that. Okay, cool. Yeah, so it seems to work. It just was on my end. So yeah, just a little quick introduction. Who am I? I'm Yannick. I'm a bass producer from Germany. I'm 25 years old. I go by the name of Jack. And yeah, I've been producing music since 2014. And yeah, ever since I've been developing as a producer, I've done a course for Bass Gorilla on Hybrid Track, Hybrid Trap production. Sorry for that. I've even did some YouTube videos for them, and yeah, this is the fourth bass time. So these are normally streams just for the Bass Gorilla members in their membership area, which were private streams the last three times, and this one is public, and I'm really excited for that. And yeah, today we will create a track from scratch. I have nothing prepared, and I'm pretty excited for that. So yeah, let's keep it rolling. I'm gonna switch over to the DAW. If you guys have any questions, just leave them in the comments. I will try to read everything. Also, make sure to join the Discord server for Bass Gorilla. I hope someone posts the link into the YouTube and the Facebook, so a few more people can join. And yeah, I think we're good to go. Switch to the DAW here. And yeah, let's just first go with a little drum groove here. So I'm just gonna lay something out real quick. I'm gonna start with the intro here. And then I have 8 bars of intro, 16 bars of intro. I will do a little build up here, and I will do a drop here. And yeah, if you guys have any questions on the go, just leave them in the comments. A little break section here. I'm just gonna lay out a little stuff here so you can see my full workflow on this. I think that's enough for now. So we will start with a little drop here. And yeah, let's just use a little kick. I'm just gonna create two new audio tracks because I'm not gonna use the MIDI ones here. And let's choose, I like to use that one a lot. It's my go-to kick lately. I've been switching out the kicks every now and then. Cool, seems like real life everywhere, Facebook and YouTube. And yeah, let's choose a little snare here. So I will go with that one for now. We can switch that out later, just to get a little groove going on here. This kick is probably a little distorted right here, so I'm gonna turn that down. Yeah, and let's just create a little groove here. And one more here, and then we can rinse and repeat that. Yeah, like super, super classic trap drums. But we will switch these up later on. I just want to have a little groove going on here first. I'm just gonna set up my sidechain real quick, and then let's create a new group in our sub channel, and I will be using some of the stuff I've been using lately. So I've broke down this little rack here last time on Bass Time. So if you aren't a Bass Time member, make sure to subscribe to their membership. It's not really expensive, and you can learn a lot of cool stuff from really sick people like Slink and Joe Ford and all these really, really highly experienced people, and myself too. And yeah, let's go with a little pattern here. Why can't I hear anything? I think because the audio was down here. Move the webcam to the bottom left. Do you think it just doesn't work on that end? Because I've switched it over from my streams, and for me, like on the upper right, there isn't anything happening that's really important. So yeah, but I can switch it down if you like to. That was the wrong one. Yeah, I have to turn on this. Oh, that is way too low. It covers the channel name. Oh, that's not good. I can switch it over if you'd like to. Just let me know. So I will just set up my kick and the sub right here. Cool. So we have that going on. And that's usually how I start, like with the sub and the kick and snare, because the kick and the sub and the drums really make the mixdown of the track. They are the loudest part, and they just have to slam. Yeah, I think something like that works for the beginning here. Yeah, cool. So let's roll with that. I have to shut down my Facebook. Sorry for all this stuff, all these notification noises. I'm just gonna mute the conversation real quick. Sorry about that. For 1 hour, and that works cool. So next up, we're gonna add some top drum stuff. So I really like these Sultan crashes. Let's go with that, and let's pull up some whites too. And yeah, I'm just gonna lay down a basic pattern here with all the drums, all the top drums. And what's really important is that you fade these in, because they can really, really clash with the snares and with the kicks. So yeah, make sure to fade them out a little bit. And this is what we got now. Yeah, that sounds good. Let's turn on the warping real quick. And then we can make them a little bit shorter and snappier. And so we can boost them in the end a bit more. So I'm just gonna, I think I have a little EQ on here too. Nope, I haven't. So let's make this a new group. Cut out all the low end on this. And yeah, I just wanna get like a basic drum groove going so we can play around with some drop stuff, some synths and all that. So yeah, let's do that and then put a free clip on to boost the hell out of them. And yeah, together it sounds like that. Cool, that's good for now. Let's call this sub. Probably I shouldn't rename anything right here because I'm really short on time. So we are in the key of D. Just gonna see what DAW am I using. I'm using Ableton Live 10. Can really recommend it. It's a pretty dope DAW. And yeah, let's see. So probably I'm not gonna sound design too much because I only have like 60 minutes on this. So I will use some sounds I've made before, and that really reflects my workflow because that's how I work a lot. And let's see what I got here. So I've made this little pack with the with some basses for Bass Gorilla. So let's just start with a little growl here. Yeah, and right now I will turn off the chops right here, but I will turn them back up just so I get a little flow going on here. And let's shorten this even more. And there are a bit, let's see if I get anything else going on. So I'm just searching for an interesting sound. So for example, that one is really, really interesting. We could use that as a little layer for later. So these are all sounds I've made in a previous, sound design session. Woo! That one is really interesting too. So I have no idea which key this is in. Unfortunately, I haven't layered. I haven't labeled this exactly, but we will find out in a bit here. Let's actually pull up a pro Q here real quick instead of a Q. So it seems like it's an F if that's true, what's happening here. And we are in the key of D, so we would need to pitch this down a bit, so let's pitch this down to an E, to an D sharp, and to an D. Yeah, let's see how this sounds. And then we could have this little thing rinse and repeat, maybe. Let's see how this sounds. Yeah, for now that works. I will shape this a bit. So let's move that over. And you can hear the sound is pretty post-processed already. Let's turn this to mono. Yeah, so it's for me nowadays it's way too stereo. It's a bit bit weird. So I'm gonna turn this back to mono and give it some stereo afterwards. So just I can push it a bit more. So I'm gonna use either the left or the right channel. I think I use the left channel because I like it a little bit more. Yeah, and then we can put on our own little process in here. So a little compressed roomy reverb. Then we will do a mid-side OTT. And let's see how this sounds with that on. Yeah, so that sounds a bit better already. It's really clipped right here, so I will put up a free clip at the end. And then let's put on an effector. I'm just trying to get like a cool sound out of it first, and then I will play with the pattern and arrange the sub around it and all that stuff. Let's use a little effector rack. So that's a little rack I've made with FL Studio's effector. Just gonna make sure actually my connection is good enough. Gonna close down two programs. So this is a little, I'm just using it for the delay. It's a really, really short delay and it gives it like this metallic vibe. Yeah, you can see here. And then I'm gonna put on a soothe at the end. Just to make sure the harsh frequencies get tamed a bit, I'm gonna turn it to mid-side mode. Yeah, it's just a little bit nicer to the ears. Also, I'm gonna pull up all of these into another group. It's the basses, and I'm gonna put on a little reverb thrower rack I've made. So we have this little first guy, which I'm not really stoked about. Maybe I will change that up too. Let's try to put this all on the group and see how the bass sounds. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. And then the cool thing about this is that we can now put on reverb throws at a certain amount of times in the track. So for example, on this little end here, we can have a little throw going into the other pattern. Yeah, so we have something like that. And maybe we put this up to D sharp. So I'm not really sure about the pitch on this one. Let's put on a frequency shifter because it kind of sounds off to me. And you probably recognize that I'm mixing at really, really high volumes. That's how I usually go. And if you're seeing some clipping on here, that's totally fine. I clip my masters. I just make sure it sounds good. And we will tame these a bit more. And the cool thing about the warping in Ableton is that you then can drag them just out. And yeah, let's maybe play a bit with that. Let's try to unwarp them and pitch them down. Yeah, that sounds pretty weird. Oops. Yeah, we will keep that for now. And we will add another layer on here. Let's see. And now we have just this little group, so everything will sound cohesive probably in the end. And let's actually just search for another little sound here. So I'm not really keen about this this sound here. So maybe that one works better. Yeah, let's play a bit around with the sub here. So we have our little noise channel. And then we can play a bit with the pitch bend too. So let's see. Yeah, that's cool. This one is way too harsh, so let's tame that a bit. And I'm just trying to get like a little bar going on here. And probably need to turn down the sub a bit more. And let's see what sound do we get here. Ooh, that's loud. I'm really sorry for your ears. And this is in, what is this, F? So we have to pull it down too, to be in a D sharp. And yeah, I'm just playing around with a few sounds here. Let's keep that pattern going. And play a bit around with that. Maybe we keep the energy a bit higher by making the pattern a bit shorter. Yeah, that's already set. And I'm not really 100% sure about that sound yet. Maybe we can do a pitch thing here. Yeah, maybe we do like a sustain sub. And then have it maybe even raise up even more. And let's see. Oops, I need to enable this little thing here. Yeah. And maybe pitch the sub up too. Yeah, so we have a little thing going on here. Then maybe we could even make a little pattern with that. Let's see. So the sub could follow these little hits here. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Really depends on the mood of the track and all that stuff. And yeah, if you guys have any questions, let me know. I'm just gonna take a look at the chat real quick. It doesn't seem like anyone has any questions right here, so. Yeah, that's kind of cool. Now we can maybe pull up the minimum value here a bit so it doesn't get completely silenced in the in-between. Let's see how this sounds. Yeah, so it just has like a little pump. Yeah, maybe we could even have this going on a bit before. So it's kind of following this little pattern here. I think we are in triplets here, so let's pull these two triplets. Okay, and then maybe we can play a bit with the pitch here. So it's going up. Yeah, that already sounds like a little loop we could have going on here. Let's turn back on the chop stuff here. Let's see how this sounds. Maybe we can turn it down a bit. Yeah, these are a little bit quiet for me. And probably we could make them a bit more interesting by adding another layer to it. And for example, just pitching this up. And maybe we can, oops, accidentally I inserted a little audio track here. That wasn't my intention. We could just... let's pull this back to where it was. Let's pull these down, and then we could deactivate the warp mode and just pitch them up so they get a lot shorter. And then now we should have a little clicky noise. Yeah, and then we could use the track delay here to delay it a little bit, for example like 10 milliseconds. Yeah, so we have another layer that's just giving a little bit of, more interest to the sound. Let's hear how this sounds a little bit delayed. And I think we have to give that a bit back. And yeah, we get in somewhere. We can maybe widen that sound a bit more up, so this little thing here. So yeah, it's just a little bit more stereo, and maybe we could even give it like a little echo. Let's see how this sounds. Turn on the reverb a bit and turn on the ducking. Turn off the... Yeah, so that sounds interesting. Let's make sure that there is no low end. Evolve here. Yeah, we could push this even more. Let's put on another free clip. And probably we have to get rid of the last ones here. Cool. And now that we have a little loop going on, I will just duplicate this and copy it over. I'm gonna copy this whole section over and this whole section over. So we have a 16 bar loop now. And I think I'm just gonna save this real quick before anything crashes. And I think then we are going to start with a little intro thing here. Because I really need to take care of the time. I only have 60 minutes for that. So, yeah. Let's see. Let's first go with a little wheeze pattern here. So we are in the key of D sharp. Let's do a really, really basic wheeze patch here. So we're just gonna turn on the unisons and put on a low cut, and we already have a wheeze here. So, and we need to have that one octave lower. So make sure to turn on your headphones or your sub pack or whatever, because we are working with low subs right here. I'm just gonna make sure the portamento is turned up to maybe 250, and so we can make some gliding notes in a bit. And also I'm gonna make sure to have a clean sub going out of this, so we can fix this with a little poke cue here again, to low cut the sides just a little bit at least, cut low sides, so we have that. Yeah, I'm just gonna make that a little bit more interesting. Maybe even we can turn on a little comb filter, for example. Yeah, let's see. So let's make a little pattern here. So maybe something like that. Yeah, that works. And actually I'm gonna turn the comp down and give it a bit of drive. Yeah, that works. Then we are going to add a little melody on top. Let's open up an Onmis here. Hope everyone is doing great in the chat. Let me know that you are in here by leaving a comment at wherever you're watching, YouTube or Facebook, or leave a comment in the Discord, just so I know you're there. So I'm loading Onmis here up here, which takes a little bit. Does anyone have any questions? I'm just gonna check the Facebook chat here. Doesn't seem so. We have a few people in YouTube here. So Omnisphere should have opened up. Let's pull this up. And I will use the little clock is ticking. Yeah, it is. I know. I will do this little trick. I showed on the YouTube channel before. To make it fit to a scale, so we need to go to D sharp, and let's put this up another octave down, and let's pull all this in front of that. So now we only have notes in the key of D sharp. So let's go into type. Actually, let's go into genre. Not genre. So belts first, and then mood, and there we can, for example, choose something like a dreamlike. So now we have only belts that sound kind of dreamlike. I'm just gonna put a little thing here, so we so we hear the sound. Let's keep this going. So maybe something like that works. Yeah, that works. How did you decide the transpose amount for the layer? I just transpose. You're talking about that one, right? About that little layer. It is just an octave above, so you see, I've pitched this down 3 semitones, 1 octave above is 9 semitones above the original sound. So yeah, it's just an octave layer. I'm gonna get back to the intro stuff here. And we need to fade these into each other, so I'm just gonna drag them a little bit out. And let's just wumble through a few of these presets here. Ooh, okay, I'm already in love with that one. Let's pull up an RC20 to just make it a bit more interesting. And I hope we're doing good in time. I have no idea. I think I like it the other way around better. Okay, now I'm here. Now the flow just kind of starts to go. So I'm thinking about something like a little clock ticking here, like tick, 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 tick. So click, clock. Yeah, not click, clock. So I think something like that works, but just doubled, so it's a bit slower, and just repitch it. And fill it with a lot of reverb. I'm gonna use vintage reverb for that. Cut the lows here, right before the reverb. And yeah, just turn that to ambience. Maybe okay, so now we get something going. Let's maybe add another little patch here. That's doing a little bit higher. Maybe something like a wheel up. So actually let's just drag this up here. And then I'm gonna use a little trick. So preset, init preset. I'm gonna get all of these notes here. And Where's the first one? So. Where are the other ones? They're kind of gone. It's crazy. Yeah, so this should work. And then we make sure that these are all shortened. And then I'm gonna use a little trick here. So I'm gonna put on the C minor scale tool. Then I'm gonna pull this up to D sharp. So now everything is in the key of D sharp that we are playing. Then we are going to use a little chord thing here, and then we are going to use a little up thing. So that should work. Let's see. Let's pull this up. I don't know, like maybe a 3 and 7. Let's see how this sounds. Maybe I can pull that up before. Yeah, just make that a little up thing here, real quick, by only doing a little thing like that. Yeah. Yeah. I'm just gonna add a few layers here. Put the same. Actually, you know what? We are not going to. Maybe we can just switch this note around. We are on the one wrong here. Where are we? The clock is ticking. So I'm not really getting the results out of that I want. So I'm just gonna make my own little up pattern real quick. I hope I get this done by that time. So let's fold this down again. And yeah. Let's keep this going by doing a little. Cool. So I'm starting to like that. So we need a few effects here. So we are pretty short on time here. Let's pull on some down sweep, down lifter. Let's just pull up a few of these. Just gonna reverse them into the next part here. And then we need a little, let's pull this in here. It's pretty short on time. Intro synths, and we need some drums going. So we have like 50 minutes left. I think we at least can make a little intro, maybe a little build, and yeah, maybe work a little bit on the job. So let's see. Probably not gonna finish the whole thing here in that short amount of time, but I think you get like a cool hang on how I would go about that. So let's use some snares. Maybe something like that. Oops, sorry. I have to deloop that. Oops. So we have a little thing going on here. Let's pull up some claps. I'm just gonna use a little drum build thing I've made a while ago. And yeah, we keep rolling with that. I have a little build up here. So turn this all the way, drag this all the way out. Have this repeat in here. Probably only like a really small part. Let's do this the same part. I think it's already the same. And now the little wheeze here needs to pitch up all the way through the build. So if any one of you has some questions, just let me know. Do some work here. Yeah, just let's get rid of all this stuff here. Let's pull up a little LFO tool here just for sidechain real quick. Yeah, just duck it out a little bit. Let's see how this sounds. And everything needs to filter up and wash out, so I will put on an auto filter and a wash out, like the name says. Yeah, and just drag that out till the end. Have a little shape like this going on. Could help. I don't know, maybe not. And yeah. Where is it gone? Okay. So, yeah. So this was a bit extreme. Let's pull up some risers. We have 8 minutes left. The clock is ticking. It is. Take a listen here. That's the wrong clock. Where's the clock? The clock is ticking. Just gonna use a little riser thing here to keep the energy going. Yeah. Let's just pull this back down. So the I'm not really satisfied with the drop right now. I try to fix that. Yeah, not really keen on. I think we have to pull the effector back to only these two channels because I don't want to have the first one affected by the effector. Affected by the effector, I'm not really sure. I've got 10 minutes. Oh, that's good. I will. Actually, you know what? Oh, I have to delete that one. Yeah, let's do that. And then let's do another pattern here. So maybe not something that fast, but a little bit different too. Just gonna add all the lanes for here. So where is this reverb coming from? Yeah, it's a bit extreme. Why is it that that harsh? Maybe we can have a little pattern like that going on. Let's keep that going. Maybe something like that, and let's change this one up a bit. This is like super distorted. Yeah. Let's see. Maybe we can have a little pitch going on here. Something like that would work. Probably. Yeah, it's just like a super quick idea. To be really, really honest, I'm not really keen on the sound selection on this. I would probably change it up a lot, but yeah, just because I have to do something here and stick to these sounds, I can't do like a totally new one, but I kind of dig the idea though. Yeah, and then we can have like a little fill sounds in here. So we already had this one here. So maybe we can have like a little donk, for example. So maybe have something like that going on. Yeah. Yeah. And then, yeah, maybe you have something like that and play a bit with some fills and stuff. Let's hear it from the beginning again, or from the middle. Yeah, so that already sounds a lot better. Yeah, so I think our time is running up here. Yeah, that's what we got so far. So I will do a little playthrough here one more time for the whole track. I'm gonna copy all this over. So we have almost a full track made here. Yeah, like I said, it's a really really rough idea. I wouldn't keep it like that, but I think for like just the yeah, so just that you get the hang of how I would start a whole track, that probably works pretty good. So I'm gonna play it through one time and then we will wrap this up. You will get the project file in the Bass Gorilla membership. I have no idea if this will be made to the public too. Yeah, probably. Yeah, I don't know. Let me know if that works. Members only, yo. So yeah, you have to be a member, but then you would get the whole project file, which is pretty sick. So let's hear this. Oh, so we have to turn this off for the intro. Forgot about that. So yeah. Yeah, and the transitions don't work yet, but yeah, I think you get the point. So this is what I came up with an hour. It's not the best track, but I think despite the track that I only had 60 minutes, it's pretty solid for that. And yeah, I hope you could learn a little bit about the workflow I have, about how I would work when I don't have much time. And yeah, are there any questions left? Anyone has anything? Let me know. It's already done. Yeah. Dope. Almost a whole track, but not really. Still missing a lot of fine-tuning and, yeah, switching over some patterns. Let's see. I'm just waiting on... I'm just gonna play a little thing here. In the background. Any questions on YouTube? Any? I'm taking a look at the YouTube right now, but bass level and next phrase after pitch up and drop. Nice job. Try keep forest stuff samples for add cinematic vibe. Yeah, for sure. If I would have more time, I would definitely add more stuff. The intro is pretty bare bones, and the build up really isn't that exciting yet, but. Yeah, if I would have more some time, I would definitely work a bit on this till it sounds better. Yeah, any more questions? Sounds good. Is it worth it finding a digital distributor? So you're talking about publishing your tracks, I think. It really, really depends on the path you want to go. So I went with a lot of self-releases, so I needed a digital distributor just to release my tracks in Spotify and Apple Music and all these different stores. When you have a label, when you release with a label, usually you don't need a digital distributor because they distribute it for you. And yeah, I hope I covered that a bit. Bass level in the next phrase after pitch up. I don't really get what you mean, but I think you mean that I need to change some stuff up here. And yeah, as I said, if I had some more time, I would have done it, but. Yeah, the time is over now. Just watching. Are there any questions on Facebook? I don't think so. So, Mo, do you have any more questions? Maybe summed up from the chat, which I haven't collected, or any questions on the stuff side? Great job, man. Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much. Was a pleasure to do these bass times. And thank you for Bass Gorilla again for having me. I'm really, really stoked to be on a roster with such high-level experienced guys. And I hope to do some work with you guys in the future, too. How you balance the mid-side levels reference... Yeah, so in the beginning, I would definitely recommend you to reference a lot of your favorite tracks and see what stuff do they actually have in their on their sides and all that stuff. So usually, because usually you tend to really overdo your stereo and the mono kind of sounds pretty flat. I kind of found my way to. Yeah, to add always like the same stereo processing kind of process, so that works for me. No questions next time. Yeah, I hope that's wrapped up the mid side stuff. Yeah, play just a bit with that. Try to have a strong sound in mono already, and then maybe add stereo on top of that. It really depends on your mixdown. Like, I don't know. It's a lot of trial and error. Does it pay well to have a digital distributor, or should I keep producing for fun? Dude, you should always produce for fun, because till the point where you make money with your career, you probably would have quit 10 times if you didn't make it for fun, I'd say. Because... Yeah, music business is really, really hard. I'm barely at the point where I'm making some money with my music, but not that I could live with that. I'm still working 9 to 5, and I will do it for a long time. I'm planning on doing this more as a business thing, but till there, it's a path for me too. And yeah, if any of you watching, I would highly appreciate it if you could follow me on my socials too. So on my socials, such as, I'm switching over to the cam, such as YouTube over here and Facebook, Twitter. I'm even having a Twitch account right now. It's also official check like that. I would love to have you as a follower. I'm trying to stream every single day, working on tracks, doing sound design, all that stuff. Would highly appreciate that. You good man, sign out. Yeah, if there aren't any advices, any questions anymore. One advice for you guy, for you, try Pro Audio DSP DSM version 3. If you don't use it, you will love it. It's a cool sound design and master. I will definitely check that out. I have no idea. Is that like a limiter or a multiband processor? Yeah, I will check that out definitely. Thanks for recommending me that. Cool. Seems like we covered all the questions. I would wrap it up now. Just waiting. Yeah, thanks, bro. Yeah, you're very much welcome. It was a lot of fun. I hope the track didn't suck too much because, I was pretty short on time. And, cool, guys. Thanks for having me again. I wish you all a really, really great day. Hope to see you next time, wherever we will meet. And yeah, please make sure to follow me everywhere. Follow Bassgorilla. Make sure to follow or to sign up for their membership because they have some great value in there. You can watch all the courses that have been done. Also my course, the Hybrid Trap Production course. And cool. So I would sign out of this.